With Everton going out the FA Cup last week, 25 seasons will have passed since you helped them win the last trophy here at Wembley and became the most decorated player in the club's history. Until Wigan defeated Manchester City, it was the last major shock in an FA Cup final. So what were your memories of that day? What was your career that it meant more to you than some of your own successes?
Yeah, because I knew the club were trying to get rid of me all the time. I knew it would be my last FA Cup ever. So yeah, it was quite a nice, quite relaxed. We had nothing to lose. Everybody got the money now to the final. So it's quite a nice, relaxing time for us. So yeah, we got a decent goal and all that, so we just defended. And the run we were on, I think we'd only got one goal in the FA Cup anyway. I think it just, once we secured relegation, or stayed in the league, sorry, before the relegation, it was just an added bonus. And I think it was only, honestly, I expected to win. I didn't have any fear going into that game because the pressure was all on anyway. But it was a nice day, and I managed to drive home on my own, and it was quite nice.
I'm an Everton supporter myself, and when I told people I supported Everton as a kid, other black and Asian people would find it hard to understand how I could follow a team that never had signed a black player. In hindsight...
Oh, they did though. If you know your history, they did.
But it's not one country to rank. In hindsight, do you think Everton's failure to sign a black player until 1994 influenced the way the fans behaved towards opposing black footballers in the 20s and John Barnes?
I don't know really. I think if you'd signed a good black player, nobody cared. I still didn't think nobody cared in them days. So barely, when I was in my age, I don't think there was any black players there. So 1994 was probably when Earl Barron before that came. So I think for them, I don't think it was a conscious decision not to sign any black players. I think it was just the way it happened. Howard wasn't a stupid manager. If he'd have found somebody who was better than what he had, whether it was green, blue or yellow, he decided. He just thought, maybe, I think he did try and sign the end of it at one stage. So I think he would have tried to sign a couple. So I think he would have tried it, but for one reason or another, maybe it might have been a fraction on that other players that might have come. They definitely done that, so I think he tried. But sometimes it just didn't happen.
Finally, yesterday, the sports minister, Ian Davies, called for an urgent meeting with football's leaders to tackle discrimination. She said those involved in abuse are not football fans. Do you think this is true? And if she consulted you, what would you advise her to do?
Take her in by, should they, seriously. That means when you have her in by, should they, at the ball, the linesman, the referee, the corner flags, the net, the mascot, the stuff around the ground, all the ball, and all that stuff. Have LGBT commentators, and in the studio, have workshops around the ground. So you're actually meeting people. Then they say, come back. Is it coming back? I don't know whether it is or it isn't. Why are they only inviting two people? Surely it's more people. Why aren't they inviting other league clubs and asking what they're doing? Because they're doing quite a bit. Or the community clubs do great work. It seems to me that sometimes the FA's want to tick box stuff. You can't tick boxes. And I think one of the things is that you use the N-word, you get sent off. If you call somebody a caller, you don't get sent off. And I think that's wrong. I think that should be addressed. And the same in the stadium, if you call somebody a N-word, you get thrown out. If you call them a caller, you don't. And I think we've got to say, well, why is one different from the other? We've got to treat everything the same. And I do think we have to make an environment where people have to come on the pitch. I still think the way to shortcut somebody is to get LGBT fans on the pitch at half time playing football. Not near your own fans. Are you going to have all your own fans? I don't think so. Yeah, some might, but that's going to be more down to being the stupidity. It's not going to be down to who they are. But the majority. majority of people will see them on the pitch and see them playing and get used to it if we do that regularly. That would be a good thing. Tell me an FA Cup final or one of the other finals that you ever see anything with LGBT around. There's our showpieces. Yeah, we don't do anything for LGBT around our showpieces. Why not? Why can't they have a tent out there and engage with fans? Why can't they have things going on in my town? The referee being in the rainbow kit. Why can't we show the world that we're taking it seriously instead of going, we'll have a talk? So they'll have a talk in a couple of weeks, and then they'll have a plan, and then another 2 weeks, and it'll be a month gone by before they do anything. But people are going to do the work with them. Why not try and work with the race yourselves and Lindsay and fix it from inside rather than trying to make a big wish list on the outside? I just think it's, to me, it's just silly. You just got to make sure that, and I'd like to see the stewards trained properly. And I'd like to see the stewards carry out cameras on their tops, you know, like the police do. I'd like to film the people and get banned for life, same as you've done. If we get that, I think we've got half a chance. But you can't just play it, you've got to stop it. If you don't stop it, it's going to carry on. Racism, have you stopped racism? Oh yeah, really. And if you go to some Eastern European countries, it's even worse. So, you know, let's get our bit done first when we go, right, what are we saying? We're saying this is wrong, so therefore if you say it, get out, and you don't come back, and we lead by example. And that means that the PFA have to be involved, so they have to make sure the players don't say anything else, the managers don't say anything, the staff don't say anything, let me connect with the club, don't say anything. And it's got to mean what it says. Stupid TikTok stuff, which is pointless. We can have an LGBTQ plus day. We can have the day and have everything connected with it done in the rainbow colours. Have things like these workshops around the grounds. You know, if we're going to have something, it's no good going to talk to people who are already converted. It's the people who want to get out of the fans in the terraces. So, what I'd also like to see is that next year's season ticket is, next year's season ticket, anybody who orders a new season ticket will have a questionnaire to fill out. And you don't need to send tickets to the EU, you send the questionnaire back. And that would all be about LGBT stuff and racism or what they actually think. And do a proper survey so that they've got something like 30,000 season tickets. Now, if you survey everybody in the league and you then look at all the evidence, you can point out and you can say that this is what we want to do, this is what we want to do. So everyone's going the same way. Yeah, we're not told this and whatever, some sort of questionnaire done properly. I think would be a good start because the people are already there. And I still think that football does get a bad name. I think the amount of people that actually go to football, it is the very, 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 very minority of opinions. But if you have that many people going to any events throughout the season, you can attract idiots. It happens in every sport. You look at the boxing. Sometimes the boxing is rubbish and they're in, you'll fight outside. You know, what does that have to be there? You know, you look at the way people are in cricket now. Cricket now, they used to be Barmy Army. The Barmy Army screwed up. I'm not saying they're racist or anything like that. But that's got a bit more lively. Or some of the games got a bit more lively. There's a bit more aggression in the matches as well. So, you know, rugby,